So Starfield user score dropped to 5.4? That must be salty PlayStation fans that's doing this, you know, or fake Xbox fans, you know, people that say they like Xbox, but deep down they hate Xbox. They might claim that they got an Xbox and they hate Xbox. Starfield user score dropped to 5.4, but this is PlayStation fans doing this. What's up, gamers? Another beautiful day. Yep. Hope your five senses work, health and strength is good or excellent.
What?
Listen to this. What's up, Tech for Gamers? Listen to this. Starfield user score dropped to 5.4 after review bomb. Sometimes people can take their reviews too far, you know? Sometimes people can take their reviews too far. I remember people review bombed Anthem. But right now, I myself still play Anthem till this day. And I think EA need to stay with that game and add some DLC and expansion to the game, because the game is that fun to play. Okay? Some people can take their reviews too far, man. Listen to this. It says here, latest game to be review bombed. And the only reason why Starfield is getting review bombed is PlayStation fans. They love to dish it out, but cannot take it. Alright? Says here, Starfield has been hit among the critics with an average rating of 85 out of 100 on Metacritic. There is little doubt that Bethesda Game Studio has created another exciting RPG. Following the full release 2 days ago, Metacritic opened the game up for user reviews. Unfortunately, the user reviews have not been that pleasant, as the critic scores mainly due to a recurring problem with Metacritic. Starfield is currently being review bombed on the platform. Why it matters? Review bombing have become a frequent problem for Metacritic recently. Games like Zelda, Tears of the Kingdom, and Final Fantasy XVI also fell victim to this sad practice. Says here, as sad as this may be, Starfield being review bombed is not surprising. The game already received a negative review on the platform several months ago, shortly before release. Many Twitter users claim to be preparing accounts to review bomb the game on Metacritic. This has led to a user score below 5.5 out of 10 for the recently released RPG. And then it shows the people who's review bombing. says here, the image above highlights the reviews that scored the game a 0 out of 10. At the time of writing, the game has over 1,100 negative reviews on Metacritic. Some have called it a sci-fi clone of Oblivion and Skyrim from Elder Scrolls franchise. Others have pointed to the lack of seamless travel from planet to planet and dated facial animation. Character models have also received criticism from users, with claims that they look several years old. Additionally, PC optimization has been frequently brought up in these negative reviews. While these points can be considered genuine criticism in many ways, they do not warrant a score of 0 out of 10 in any way. Even Starfield harshest critics agreed that the game can be very engaging once it gets going. Certain media outlets have given the game low scores, but such scores have ranged from 7 to 7.5 out of 10. Therefore, there is little doubt that such user on Metacritic only intend to bring the game overall rating down. Starfield is the first-party title for Xbox, which pushed it at the forefront of the raging console war between fans on the internet. Unfortunately, should this course has been nothing but harm the credibility of user score on Metacritic. Previously, games like Horizon Forbidden West were also review bombed for ridiculous reasons, leading to hopes for a solution to this growing trend on platforms. Nonetheless, the user score has not had much of an impact on the game's success. Phil Spencer has confirmed Starfield reached over 1 million current players recently, becoming a massive success for Xbox and Bethesda Game Studios. And that is that. Look, this article brought up Tears of the Kingdom. Now, Tears of the Kingdom deserve to be review bombed. Why? Because the Wii U brought some things to the table that can never be ignored when it comes to video games. And most people, I would say the whole lot of people, when they talk about the Wii U, they don't do a thorough video. They leave the Wii U Pro controller out, but then they hide the 3DS in the background, and then try to say, oh, the Wii U was a failure. But then the same people who make those videos, they turn around now and then they make a 3DS video and then say, oh, the 3DS is better than the Wii U, when it's actually not. My explanation of the Wii U situation is the best on the internet, period. The reason why Tears of the Kingdom got, in my estimation, the reason why the Tears of the Kingdom got such a low review is because of what the Wii U brought to the table. Number one, the Wii U had the Miiverse. So that means you could take picture shots of the game and put it in the community, and then you had the Miiverse where you can draw the characters. The other key ingredient now is that the Wii U gave the Nintendo fans options to play. They had the ability to use the Wii U Pro Controller, the console, and the TV without the tablet, right? Then they had the option of using the tablet, the console, and the TV, and no Wii U Pro Controller. Then they had the other ability now to use the Wii U Pro Controller, the tablet, the console, and the TV. And then what also the Wii U brought to the table was that dual screen feature that you have on Breath of the Wild that you don't have on the Switch. That is why Tears of the Kingdom got a 5 point. I gave it a 5 out of 10 for that specific reasons. Okay, because you don't have those functionality and utilization of Zelda like you would, like Breath of the Wild on the Wii U. That's why I gave Tears of the Kingdom a 5 out of 10. And there's solid reasons. It's not just made up. Now, when it comes to Starfield, that's a whole different ballgame The PlayStation fans, they love to dish it out, but they can't take it. They love to make fun of Xbox, but then when the shoe is on the other foot, they don't like to wear it. So remember, Sony started all this when they kept Final Fantasy VII Remake to themselves, right? And the PlayStation fans was rubbing it into the Xbox fans' face. Then Sony turned around and got the rights to Spider-Man. And then the Xbox fans missed out on that. So I guess Phil Spencer is like, okay, all right. We're going to respond to this. Like telling the Xbox fan base, like, don't worry about this. We got this. We're going to respond to this. And they, Microsoft went out and got ZeniMax Bethesda. The news was announced on a Sunday morning. That's, I remember that to this day. They went and bought ZeniMax Bethesda for $7.5 billion, right? Just to send a message to Sony to let them know that they meant business. They're here to play. Then Microsoft turns around and bought Activision Blizzard. That's a whole other story. But Starfield now, the PlayStation fans, they're salty that Starfield is not on PlayStation. That's why the game is getting such review bombed, okay? Because the PlayStation fans, they love to if the PlayStation fans can't get stuff to go their way, if they can't get stuff to go their way, then they'll start review bombing, you know, and then bring down the value of Starfield. But you know, Microsoft, you know, bought ZeniMax Bethesda, you know, and the PlayStation fans should, to me, they should never be salty, but PlayStation fans are just PlayStation fans. So 5.4 in review. The game is actually better than that, you know. So, you know, then you have the people who talking about Starfield before you buy. They go on YouTube, Starfield before you buy. Wait a minute, and they never played the game. I have seen YouTubers talk about Starfield three times, and the game wasn't even released yet, and they never played it. They were making fun of Xbox and. Oh, is this when Xbox get to go over the hump, so to speak? They talk about Starfield in such a negative way before the game even hit the market, and they were trying to bring down the value of the game. But then when the game comes out now, they try to review it, and then all of a sudden they want to change their tune. They're YouTubers that does that. So to me, Starfield. It's just, to me, it's just salty PlayStation fans. All the negative reviews that Starfield is getting is from PlayStation fans who are not Xbox fans. That's where all this reviews is coming from. So, I haven't even played the game yet, but I will get around to it once I get through some games that I need to finish. But I will play it when I get to it. But a lot of the negative reviews that Starfield is getting, is from PlayStation fans. You know, they're just mad that Microsoft bought ZeniMax Bethesda, and they're not going to be able to play they're not going to be able to play the Bethesda games like they used to. so they're taking out their anger on Starfield. You know, to try to bring the game down, so to speak. You know, so that's just PlayStation fans, man. If they can't get stuff to go their way, they act like spoiled little babies without a pacifier, man. And that's how they act. You know, they think Sony got they say Sony got the best exclusives. Not anymore. They don't. They don't have the best exclusive. Microsoft do now. So, Phil Spencer talking about his decision on Elder Scrolls 6. If Phil Spencer needs to keep Elder Scrolls 6 on Xbox, you know, just to send a message to Sony, you know, that's what I would do. But that's just me. But other than that, man, I haven't played the game yet. You know, I haven't even played it. But I'm not gonna let a negative review stop me from playing. I'm not gonna let a negative review stop me from playing the game. You know, I will play Starfield before I play Baldur's Gate. That's just me. I like games that deal with outer space. That's just me. Maybe one day I'll get to Baldur's Gate, but I'll play Starfield before I play Baldur's Gate. Yeah. But other than that, man, the negative reviews are from PlayStation fans. All those negative reviews are from PlayStation fans. That's where all this is coming from. You know, they're mad that Starfield is not on PlayStation, and that's what, and you're seeing it in the reviews. You know, you're seeing it in the reviews. So yeah, but Starfield has 1 million users. 1 million users. I mean, actually yesterday I seen an article where it says 6 million users now. So 5.4. Reviews by user score. That's by PlayStation fans, huh? Those are all PlayStation fans. That's not Xbox. You know, all that bringing the game down to that low. That's PlayStation fan. Meaning that game sites that are PlayStation fans, like IGN or even GameSpot, and then the PlayStation user base as a whole. So, yeah. I mean, they just Sony. I just seen. I think somebody on YouTube just did a video where, one of the people that work at Sony played Starfield, and they were trying to get her fired. You know, they were trying to get one of the Sony employees getting fired from playing Starfield. So yeah, all that negative review, that's all PlayStation fans, man. Yeah. Now we know who PlayStation fans are, you know, so yeah. 5.4, the game score is higher than that. You know, they're just mad because it's not a PlayStation exclusive. That's what they're mad about. Hey, but Xbox fans get to laugh now. Get to laugh at the Sony fans. That's what they should do. Just saying. Other than that, man, I said Starfield was going to be game of the year. And I still believe it till this day. But my assessment on Tears of the Kingdom stands. Because to me, Nintendo should have never built the Switch. That's just me. Nintendo should have never built the Switch because I've played every Nintendo console that I've seen. Except one, the Switch. Been down that road before. The Wii U was actually better. So yeah, that's why I gave Tears of the Kingdom a 5 out of 10 to this day. You know, and I'm basing on my and I'm basing it of my experience with Breath of the Wild. Just saying. So yeah. But other than that, man, Starfield review bombing is just salty PlayStation fans. You know, they love to dish it out, but they can't take it. that's just what this is. Salty PlayStation fans, man. They're mad. Good product, but if you're looking for a bad, non-existent optimization of Broken Promise, space exploration, same old engine as any Bethesda game, pointless. Bill making. It's just PlayStation fans, man. Yeah. Well, yeah. Other than that, man, I think I will play that game before I play Baldur's Gate, though. Definitely. Because I like outer space games. Yep. He said, I already played Skyrim and Oblivion. I didn't need to play them again. Reskin those games with outer space. Had to quit when I landed on the planet with my own home and had to run away to get to my house. Nope. We're pretty irritated playthrough after all the false advertisement about exploration and how incredible it is. It would be, unfortunately, it's monthly just fast traveling to very location through means facial animation. You could say the same thing for Destiny, you know? Anyway, man. It's just salty PlayStation fans. That's all. Just salty PlayStation fans. That's all. That's why Starfield is getting all the hate. Yeah. What else on this? Nothing else. Salty PlayStation fans. Yeah. Yeah. But me, I'm definitely playing the game because I like games that deal with outer space. Yeah. I'm a sci-fi person. Star Wars. Anyway, I'm gonna leave this video for y'all to enjoy. But 5.4, the score is higher than that. It's even higher than a 7. The 5.4 reviews are salty PlayStation fans. Bottom line. Anyway, hope you enjoyed the video. Nice talking to you people again, Chris. Still a Star Wars thing. Poor Dark Side. Go. Base.